Good afternoon. Now, she's only 20 and she's talking like this. What am I supposed to do? Mind you, multiply, add a bit more. Anyway, my name is Flora Mtahi, CEO of Melvin's Tea. So I started doing my accounting. Is that better? I started doing my accounting and I was employed for all of a year. I got to work week one. By the end of the month, my boss had already seen this one is like, come and work with me. So I started working with her accounts. Of course, now you know you've got the boss's favor. I started coming to work at 10. Then I leave at 3. Because the day you call me for those plans she's talking about, I'm off. I come the next day. They got to a stage where I actually took off for a week. And when I came back, I told her, "Unataka ku, do you like some new clothes? I had gone to Dubai." And the women, we are such suckers. She completely forgot to blast me. She said, "Yeah, that one looks nice." I've not come to work for a week. She didn't even have that discussion. Anyway, so I did, I sort of worked, and then I realized, no, this is not for me. This doesn't work. So I wrote a letter, and I came home and told my folks, happily, by the way, both my parents were in business, and I came home and I said, "When are we in business?" They're like, "What?" I said, "Yeah." That's me. "What do you want to do?" And of course, you get that long, we know it. And they told me I'm a failure and everything. But fortunately, I had a friend I used to talk to, and he was like, "No, stay there, do what you want to do." So I had an interest in manufacturing, I think purely because I had friends. When in the audit company I was working for, we were auditing manufacturing companies. So I sort of knew them. I used to walk around. I sort of knew how sort of things used to work. And I said, "Okay, now what am I going to do?" I went out to the shops, and I said, "Kenya, we have, do you know this sticky salt? You know salt that sticks?" And then what do we normally do? We add rice, because the rice absorbs the moisture. So I was like, "Why don't we have this in Kenya?" So I went to universities, and I started asking guys, "Why don't we have this thing?" And they're like, they couldn't even fathom. They're like, "No, I mean, we put rice." And I said, "This is what I want to do." So I went, and we developed it with the University of, what was it? Kabete, the food department. I did that for a few weeks, and then I came back home and I did my business plan, and I said, "You know what? I need this much money." And my folks are looking at me like, "And your point could be what?" I said, "I need money." And they're looking at me like, "Find it. Where do we come in? So we've taken you to school, we've given you everything you need. Actually, you know, you should actually be planning to move out by now." So I went to, I think what she's saying about friends, friends who support you, I had a good network of friends. And my friend told me, "Let's go and look." She was also looking for something to do. And we went to Kenya Women Finance Trust, and they had this scheme where if you put a little bit of money, they would give you some. So I said, "All I have to do is get a sponsor to put a fixed deposit in the person's name, then the bank will give you, now the young person." But the condition is you have to do a business plan. Anyway, I did all that, and I did get a sponsor. Of course, I might tell you, as the ladies are here, would you leave a child of yours to really struggle? So my mother behind my dad's back. But she made it very clear to the bank manager, "It's in my name. Do you understand that? This loan is in her name. Do you understand that?" And the manager was like, "Sorry, you still can't hear." And the manager was like, so the manager said, fine, it's her loan and this is your FD. The only way we recall it is if she doesn't repay. Mark you, I'm being given like a quarter of what I need. But I told them, it's okay, I'll do it. So I started, I went to industrial area, made my machines, and I started doing my salt. It was a simple machine, cost me a lot. So the day I went to pick it, I went and 6 checks to pay for the machine, and he's telling me, "What's this?" I said, "No. See, you'll be banking it every month. It's written on the 30th. It has your name. It's money." And this man looks at me. I got away with that one. So I did a couple of those. I started now producing the salt. I actually produce it in the morning and get into my car, my personal car, and go and sell in the afternoon, Chandarana and everywhere else. So I went, I sold. So small orders. And you'd imagine I've hit it, I've brought a new idea. You're always taught in business innovation. I could see the money, I could see the new beamers, I saw it all. A ton of salt is what at that time was 2,000 bob. How many tons of table salt can you sell? I hadn't seen that. So I started getting demoralized. This is month 3, I'm demoralized, I don't know what to do. So I met a friend, a guy who was selling in a hotel. And so he went and said, "This is a brilliant idea. This is what we've been needing in Kenya. I want an order of 100 dozen. And I look at him and said, I can't do it. I don't have the money. So again, back to my suppliers, we negotiated. I started giving them the same story. I gave them many checks. Let the checks start bouncing. Of course, I don't have working capital, but I'm not stopping. So I went, I delivered, so I'm called. Madam, your check is bounced. I'm bringing the money on Thursday. Madam, your money has bounced. I'm bringing the money next week, whatever. Eventually, the bank manager said, listen, you're not, and that time, by the way, there was no penalty for bouncing a check, maybe 300 or 200 more, which I cared nothing about. All I cared was to get my product on the shelf. So anyway, cut a long story short, he called in now this secret investor and said, listen, I'm a parent. There are not many people who have such a driven person. Try and support this person. Nothing doing. All she did is she went with me to the suppliers and told them, when it ikiwa kubaya sana, yani, the day you want to auction her, come to me. But otherwise... But right now, let her follow, let her do what she wants. So, and me, I thought, here we go, now I've got a, you know. Anyway, so I continue my struggle. When I went to this guy at the hotel, lesson number one in business, they pay in 90 to 120 days. Me, I thought I'd be paid tomorrow. So anyway, go on with my working capital. Then he's sitting there and he's telling me, you know, my mom is disturbing me. She's really disturbing me. She wants money. She started packing tea. So I said, tea? Why tea? So he told me, no, you didn't know the government monopoly, the Ketepa used to have a monopoly 19 years, it's been lifted. You should see the margin. So he did. That time I'm thinking, By the next week, I was in Mombasa. I learned about tea. I registered my company, and I came and said, even me, I'm packing tea. So then again, back to my innovation, and I said, but Ketepa's been there so many years, what do I do? Then I used to come home in the evening. If I didn't have any ginger in my tea, I used to come back and go to the shop, buy and come back. So I said, how many people are like me? This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to have a plain tea and a ginger tea. So I packed them, I went. Of course, the drama is still following me. Bouncing, checks, everything you can think about. I don't pay my suppliers. Ducking and diving, I was excellent, excellent. So anyway, I take my product again, I go to Uchumi. So I go and I'm telling them, Sasa, I've got an innovative product, this is what I want. Man looks at me. Tells me, call me about next month. I say, no. He insists. So I leave, I say, okay, fine. He called me the next day. He said, hiyo chai hiko na tangawizi hiyo. Hiyo lete. Lete hapa. Immediately. Tomorrow, I want 100 cartons of land. You'd imagine I would learn something. Anyway, so I deliver. I struggle. I deliver in piecemeal. Let me tell you, if there's anything I'm excellent at. Negotiation. And you're not, I'm not negotiating because of, I'm negotiating because I don't have, but I want to achieve. So I tell them, okay, now, gari liharibika. actually, the machine. Actually, najua chai natoka Mombasa. Ile gari litoka, you know, I had every excuse in the book. So anyway, cut a long story short, we are now, 17 years old on the tea, and about, I think, 15... No, a bit older, 18 on the salt. Struggles have been many, very many. Of course, capital was a big one. I think I didn't take time to learn, you know, what to expect, the cycles of business. There's a lot of things that used to catch me, you know, flat on the face. But all in all, it's been good. So for those of you who are in employment, say you want to start business, plan. Don't overplan, by the way. The good thing, even till today, when I want to have a new idea, I don't plan too much. A little bit of research, I put in what I can afford to lose, and I say, listen, I'm going to do this, and then if it catches up, then I support it. And basically that is how I've grown. For me, innovation is a key thing. You always do something different. Don't go the normal route. I find people, this one starts at kiosk selling this one wants to start. Ladies, I'm sorry, it's always I want to do a saloon. There are so many saloons. Fine, by the way, we spend crazy money in saloons, I know, but what is gonna be different about you as? So basically, that is all I would have to say. What did Centonomy, first of all, why did I go to Centonomy? By then, I was, 15 years in my business or 16 years in my business? I was dragged. I didn't even have the opportunity, like you people, to sit here and say, my brother, you have to go, and you're going with your husband, and you have to go, and you have to go. It's like, hi, this kid. Anyway, so we went. What changed for me when I was there? When you're running your own business, you think, umefika, nimefika. Every Kenyan's dream is to start their own business. I've done it. Of course, you're not, you haven't reached where you want to go, but you're thinking, I've done it. But the thing you always forget is wealth creation for yourself. So the business, we are excellent at, and I'm there, I've got a, I'm not doing very well, I find out, how do I improve? I'm told, put a board of governance. I go, report, we go. How about me? What is in it for me as a CEO? If somebody came today and took Melvin's away, what would I say I have? I'm thinking it's not. Melvin's is a business that is taxed. And, I mean, it goes through its own, it's a business on its own. So for me, from the time I did Centonomy, which is like 3 years ago, I've now learned to create wealth away. In fact, now I negotiate my salary like you guys. I'm there saying, before I used to be so, you know, let me take less because I want to get into this project. These days I'm like, Ebu, pay me fast. I do entertainment, I'm there, the accountant. Ebu, niandiki a check quickly in my name. I spent for the business. So I think now that's what has changed. The whole idea of wealth creation. Every year I have a big goal for my, not big, I have a goal for myself, and I say, I personally, in my own right, have to have an investment separate from that one.